What's poppin', T-Squad? It's me, Keisha, and I'm here with tonight's All T, All Shay, Love & Hip Hop Miami, Season 3, Episode 2 Review. Before we get into behind the scenes, see, I want to make it clear to you guys that if I don't post a video for a one of the shows I'm reviewing, that does not mean that I've stopped doing reviews. I just missed the week. If I don't post the video that night or the next day, it won't be up. So you don't have to inbox me or ask me in the comment section, where's the video? Did I stop doing videos? I just simply missed the week. I was tired. I didn't feel like doing it. I'll let you guys know if I ever do decide to stop doing reviews on a particular show. I always do. So I just wanted to get that out of the way. I will be resuming Growing Up Hip Hop reviews this week. Now on to my behind the scenes tea for Love & Hip Hop Miami. If you do not know, Trick Daddy was arrested in Miami-Dade County Saturday morning on a cocaine possession charge. Here is his mugshot. Now, I know he has, what is it, lupus or something like that, which or Lyme disease. I think it's lupus that has, you know, his face and stuff looking like that. But what does it have to do with his haircut? I don't know what is going on with the haircut. I don't know if that happened when he got pulled over by the police. Did they accidentally shave his head? What is happening? I'm perturbed. I feel disrespected. I just don't know what is this about. Did he get high and pull out the clippers and nod it off and it went zzz and it fucked up the front part of his head? I just need answers. I need answers. I need a haircut immediately. So the report says he was arrested for drinking under the influence and cocaine possession. The incident seems very concerning as the police reports revealed that a Miami-Dade officer responded to a call of a driver hitting signs and running red lights in a Range Rover around the area of Southwest 128th Avenue and 42nd Street in Miami. When the officer approached the driver's side of the vehicle, he saw the driver appeared to be asleep behind the wheel. The officer reportedly knocked on the window to wake the man, identified by his driver's license as Maurice Samuel Young, Trick Daddy's birth name. From there, Trick let the officer know that he had left a club in Miami Gardens and later confessed he had about five drinks hours earlier at the club. The report noted that Trick had slurred speech, bloodshot, watery, glassy eyes, and that the officer smelled alcohol in his breath. So I hope he gets it together. You know, I know dealing with lupus or whatever disease he has to be hard on him and his body, and having the physical change to his looks and stuff probably has really bothered him over the years, but cocaine ain't the move, playboy. I hope he get that shit together and get help, because I don't want to see another rapper gone too soon. Also on Trick Daddy News, in the comment section, a lot of you were saying that you were wondering if he wanted to stay married to Joy because they have children with each other. So instead of just going off what I see on the internet, I actually did some research. So aside from dealing with his ex-wife on screen and bringing his new girlfriend around the show, Trick Daddy has other complicated facets of his personal life. It's been reported that the rapper has a whopping 10 kids, with his youngest reportedly being born in 2017. Trick Daddy also comes from a big family, and it's been reported that he has as many as 20 half-siblings. He has opened up in the past about how his mother had 11 kids with 10 different daddies. He also said that his success helped him take care of his family, but he's since run into some hard times. Trick Daddy is apparently having issues supporting some of his own 10 children financially. In October 2019, the rapper filed for bankruptcy in Florida as first reported by The Blast. According to a paperwork obtained by the entertainment site, Trick Daddy claimed to have been more than $800,000 in debt. He also apparently said at the time that he had $0 in his bank account. The documents also stated that he owed nearly $60,000 in child support at the time of his filing, and his estimated earnings in 2019 would be around $50,000. It was his fourth time filing for bankruptcy. Trick Daddy has also said that he is done having children. He does not share any children with Joy. They do not have children together. Smart girl. Also in Love & Hip Hop news, you know, tonight was the return of Jocelyn, the Puerto Rican princess, my idol. So she did an interview this week with The Breakfast Club, and she had some very interesting things to say when they asked her what made her return to Love & Hip Hop And does she get along with Mona? She had this to say.
It's three names that were involved in that, and she won one of them. And she said she's a talent scout. She scouts talent. You know?
Okay, I always looked at that show like that was Mona's show.
No, that's VH1 shows. VH1 owns the show.
Okay.
She don't own the show. I own Johnson & Scabbard, right? Mm-hmm. VH1 owns Love & Hip Hop.
So who wanted you to come? Did you want to go back to Love & Hip Hop, or did they ask you to come back?
You know, actually, can I just tell you this? I went back to do a few. I did a few cameos. I popped in and popped out. They gave me a great bag just to pop in and pop out. Mm-hmm. But I really did it. I really just, my baby daddy called me. I was like, listen, you know, they all, you know what I'm saying? Like, just.
They got a bag. Let's get this bag.
Just go ahead. So I did a couple of things. I did a couple of pops in and pop out. But, you know, anywhere I pop in and pop out, it's going to be fucking great. So they're making a big deal about it. But, like, really, there's nothing that I could possibly do for them because I don't own the shit. Mm-hmm. You know, so they know if I don't step foot back in there, they're going to go down. You know, and I kind of did it to fuck with them. I kind of just did a pop-up or two just to fuck with them to alter their ratings because I wanted that alteration on the in that rating sheet to go like this. Mm-hmm. You know, just to...
So when you pop up, the ratings go up, and then when you pop out, back down.
Back down. You know, and I could be a little bitch sometimes. I did it on purpose. You know, I did that. I show my ass, you know? Because my main focus is Jocelyn Scabaret.
So there you have it. She and Mona are still not cool. She only did the show for the bag. Obviously, Mona does not have as much power as we think she does. VH1 made a decision to have her back. She got the bag. She did a couple of cameos, so don't expect to see her on every episode. And she did what she had to do. And one thing I will say about Jocelyn, her return to television has been huge. She was gone for 3 years. She was quiet. She was raising Bonnie Bella, dating Ballistic Beats down there in Miami. And now she's back and on 4 television shows. She'll be on Love & Hip Hop Miami. She'll be on Love & Hip Hop Atlanta. She has Jocelyn Cabaret, which premieres next week or either this week on Zeus Network, which is her own show that she exec producer owns the right to. And then she'll be on Marriage Bootcamp. So the girl, and you know, they get paid $200,000 to film for 2 fucking weeks. So say what you want about Jocelyn, the bitch is a hustler. She done came back with a motherfucking impact. And I also say about her that the interview that she did with The Breakfast Club was actually very good. Like, Jocelyn is not what you think that she is. Like, she got her nasty, freaky side. You know, she ratchet. She'll fight you. She cuss or whatever. But she's also very, very smart. She knows a lot about the business. She's all about trying to own her own stuff, not work for anybody else, put other people on. And she's very smart. Like, I was even shocked at a lot of the things that she was saying in the interview. So check the interview out. Also, it's being reported that her and Ballistic Beast might already be married.
Stand down.
Yeah, you gotta stand down. I pretty much just.
That's a married man right there. Yeah, you're learning fast.
And stuff, if she starts getting more crazy, I'm like, you know what? Shut up, B.
He's wearing a wedding ring and she has on a wedding band and the engagement ring that he gave to her. So if they are married, congratulations to them. They make a really good couple, and she's been calm and collected since she's been with him. You haven't heard about her being in the news, her wilding out like she used to. The cocaine accusations have all been gone since she stopped messing with Stevie, and a lot of that did have to do with Stevie. When he would get mad at her, he would accuse her of being on drugs. Now, not to say that she didn't have her episodes. We all remember when she was in that booth, you know, high as a kite, my nigga. But the girl was young. It seems like she's grown up. And she's maturing, and I'm liking what I'm seeing. So, on to tonight's episode, though. So, MJ tells Amara that she should have told Shay she invited JoJo, and, you know, so none of that shit would have went down. She understands Shay's feelings, but feels it was about her that night, and that Shay should just been like, you know, I'm upset with you, but, you know what I'm saying, we'll deal with this later because you got this performance or whatever. MJ says he sees both sides and says that she and Shay need to talk. Amara says, you know, if she would have stayed, she would have seen that I got this, you know, because she ended up telling JoJo she never wants to be friends with her again. And I just feel like there was not a miscommunication. I do feel like she should have gave that girls a hit. I feel like Amara should have gave Shay the heads up, but I do feel like Shay did too much and overreacted because she makes everything about her. But I feel like they'll be able to work past this. She then brings up the Julian situation, and MJ says, if he steals from you, you know where I stand on it. Amara says, you know, I think he's just misunderstood. I just don't see him like that. And he was like, if you think he didn't treat him like that, what the fuck you think he gonna do to you? So we're introduced to Briscoe. He's a rapper that just got out of prison for credit card fraud and selling counterfeit notes. He thanks God that he got locked up because he was obnoxious and a liar and he needed to sit down. They was playing some of his music in the background. I actually really liked what I heard. Like, he really had a nice sound. His voice sounded different from anybody else. I liked it. He signed the Cash Money. He wants to do a record with Trick and Trina. I like him so far. So Trina goes to Trick restaurant. He tells her he loved the remorse she had for her mom and that her mother's death gave him an understanding about life. It worked. He tells her no matter what they go through, he's going to be there for her always. And I love their relationship together. You know, they got the radio show in Miami popping. Trick and Trina are just a great dynamic duo. Like, they're going to continue to get money with each other for the rest of their life. She tells him she wants to do an all-girls tour. And then she's going to hold auditions for different, you know, rap females in the area to go on tour with her. He tells her about Nicki Natural. And Trina's like, you know, I'll see her and see what she got going on. But okay, nigga. And so it's the day of the auditions. Joy comes to support Trina. Trina tells her that Nicki is there. And Joy don't even trip. She's like, all right, we're going to see what she got to offer. So Nicki hits the stage. And I was looking like, what is she doing? Is this Apollo, Night at the Apollo? Like, is she doing stand-up? Like, I didn't understand if it was a rap, if it was a poem, if she was doing spoken word. I don't know what the fuck she was doing. It wasn't on beat. It was long pauses in between. Then she would twirl around and then drop it down. I was like, what are you doing? Like, she was making a fool out of herself to me. But for some reason, Trina was talking about she liked it. And I was like, what did we not see? What was edited out? Because she looked ridiculous to me. She looked like a damn fool. And even Joy was like, you really see you taking that on tour? Like, what? Okay. So, this girl named JD would get up there and she clowned. Her bars was on point. Her flow was on point. Her voice, everything. I liked her, her aggressiveness, everything was on point. Then Sukiana, who I just learned from my best friend, is this girl on Instagram or whatever, that's a stripper or whatever, and she be doing a lot of funny videos or whatever. But I never knew who she was until last week. She gets on stage with her dance. She said, I'm Trina's daughter. I was like, okay, miss. So she gets up there and you rap a bunch of nasty shit. And she got her dances, male and female, they're clapping their ass and twerking and pussy popping on the handstand and doing the percolator. And she gave us a show. And she really gave you a motherfucking show. That's how you come and audition. So, of course, she's in. So Trina tells Nicki and JD that they need to battle each other for the last spot. Nicki get on the mic and say she not battling nobody. And Trina tell her she got so much mouth and the baddest bitch, which is her, wins. So get to it. So Nicki said, I'm not battling nobody again. Trina snatches the mic and JD starts to rap. Nicki trying to take the mic away from Trina and she being hella disrespectful. Then she go over to the DJ booth, tell them to turn their mic off, including Trina's. Trina like, I'm finna cuss her the fuck out. She said, you're not ready for tour. She shitted on you and you're mad. Go back and tell Trick Daddy you lost. She was like, I already been co-signed by Trick. And she said, I'm the star in this bitch. And she just doing the most. I'm like, is this bitch on high off bath salts? Is she on opioids? Like, what the fuck? Like, she was showing her ass. She was a totally different bitch from the bitch she was on last week's episode. And when I told y'all last week that bitch was full of shit. I peeped that shit from a mile away. That bitch is a user and she full of fucking shit sitting up here talking about some she's celibate. As soon as she got her ass on that stage and I saw that tattoo on the back of her thigh leading up to her ass, I was like, bitch, please, only hoes get tattoos like that. So when they bend over and that nigga fucking them from the back, he could be looking at her thigh tattoo. Great way to get the fuck out of her. So Trina tell her she got she basically get booed off stage, and I just couldn't believe it. I was like, Trina have that better me, because I'm going to slap the shit out that little bitch. She was being totally disrespectful. So Trick goes to the studio with Chaotic, and he tells him that Nicki is wearing him out. And I was like, that's what you get for messing with these young hoes, these baby bitches. And he tells Chaotic what she did at the audition. Nicki walk in looking like a motherfucking gladiator, look like she on the show, like she one of the extra wrestlers from off Glow, off Netflix. I was like, bitch, what's your wrestling name? Neon? Girl, where is you going? She looks stupid as fuck. So she walked all up on Trick, getting all up in his face and shit. Another little bird bitch, like, trying to intimidate a grown man with your little bitty ass. He get up and fling your stupid ass. So Trick say, did they ask you to do another song? And Nikki say, I'm not battling no bitch. I already won. Trick say, is Trina successful? She say, she alright. I mean, her last album ain't do good. Trick say, you talking about her last album? What your first album did? Like, bitch, you ain't got nothing. How the fuck you gonna sit up here trying to talk about somebody that did more than your ass will probably ever do in your fucking life? You look disrespectful, bitch. You look broke ass version of Nicki motherfucking Minaj and shit. Girl, you the Play-Doh version. Girl, get your ass out of here. So Nicki say, it's gonna do motherfucking amazing. Trick say, if you a rapper from Miami, you gotta respect Trina. If not, you ain't gonna make it. Nicki say, I do respect Trina. Do she respect me is the question. Who are you? Who are you, ho? Like, who are you? Girl. So she say, Joy on the panel judge me. She don't know shit about music. And Trick say, she know a lot about music. She married Trick Daddy Dollars, who did 7 albums while we were together. 5 of them platinum and 3 of them gold. Nicki say, Nicki didn't get up, get all up in his face like she doing something. He was like, girl, sit down. I'm like, girl, what is up with these little bitches thinking they can boss up on a nigga and whoop their ass? And then once again, as soon as the nigga hits you, you run into the police crying. Girl, y'all niggas better stop fucking with these little ratchet ass bitches that's gonna get fuck up y'all life. Cause that's the type of bitch right there that's gonna fuck up your life. So, she say, you team Joy or team Nicki? And she say, maybe if y'all were divorced, Joy wouldn't be in the picture. Trick say, Joy is in the picture for the rest of her life. And I said, you better speak a motherfucking word. You got him fucked up when it come to Joy. So Trina meet up with Amara LaNegra to talk. And Amara, you know, is still very starstruck by Trina. And Trina like, girl, what you got to say, bitch? I got to go. So she asks her, you know, if you see a train about to hit me, please save me. Like, what is going on with you and Julian? Trina say, I suggest you look for a new manager, darling, because he is not about to be able to work with anybody in this industry by the time I'm through with his ass. And I was like, yes, Trina. So Trina tells her the things he did is beyond repair and that she trusted him with her life. He got a deal for over 300 G's in her name and didn't give her a dime. He didn't call to say, you know, he was sorry about her mother's death and that she hated him. And she's being sued by all the producers off her last album because they didn't get paid. And I believe Trina. Trina ain't never caused no problems in the industry. She about her business. You don't hear her being in no mess or whatever. So I believe everything that she's saying. Trina tells her to look into her own situation. Amara say, you know, things have been slow for me lately. And Trina says, why you think you the only person that worked with him? So Trina and Trick meet up on a yacht with Jocelyn and Ballistic Beats. She says, you know, she love him. That is bae. She asks what's going on in the city, like who they need to introduce her to. And they say, Trick tell her that Prima Donna's in town. Josh say, you talking about the girl that sell the waist trainer, but it's still being shaped like a refrigerator? I was like, no, she ain't been watching my reviews. That was one of my lines, girl. So Trick laughed. Trick couldn't even do nothing but laugh. So she says that she has a problem with her piggly attitude. Prima Donna apparently and Jocelyn had got into it some time ago, and Prima Donna made Coca Lean shirts and was accusing Jocelyn of being on coke. Now Jocelyn don't fuck with her. So Trina tells them how Nicki showed out at her audition, and Trick said, I'm gonna let her know she made a fool out of me. So Briscoe talks to his son about being there for him now that he's out of jail, and his son admits that he was upset with him when he got locked up. Briscoe apologized to him for messing up, but swears he's gonna do right. And I like the conversation that he had with his son because he was very apologetic. He had, you know, admitted what he did was wrong. He took 100% responsibility for not being there for him and for getting locked up. I really appreciate how he handled it. Because, you know, most niggas just try to sweep that shit under the rug. Amara is at the photo shoot and Julian stopped by. She tells him what was said about him via Trina. Amara says she legally suing you. And he says, no, I don't believe him. He says that the 300 G's was his. It was a separate deal that had nothing to do with Trina. But who just giving you $300,000? And for what? What was the deal for? So, Amara say she's talking about suing you and that will affect me. Julian says it's a miscommunication that's getting to her head. What kind of miscommunication? communication, sir. He said, I got paperwork. Amara says, have you ever stole money from me? And Julian says, hell no. Amara says, everywhere I go, I hear some fucked up shit about you. And Julian said, you wait and see when I bring you that platinum plaque. And she was like, Julian, please just fix this. And then the episode goes off. I see lies upon yonder hills when it comes to Julian. He just looked like a shiesty little beady-eyed motherfucker. Then we gonna find out later in the season that he tried to fuck Amara one night. Like, boy, all right. I give tonight's episode of Love & Hip Hop Miami an A. Tonight was good because of Trina, the baddest bitch, and the other baddest bitch, Jocelyn Hernandez. Make sure you guys thumbs up this video, hit that notification bell button so y'all know when my videos drop, and let's talk down below in the comment sectiones. I love you guys. I'm about to go to sleep. I have not been to sleep in 24 hours. Love you. Goodbye.